the punks just took it in broad daylight. And it took me a while to realize what was going on. I just kept looking for it.
Luckily, Jeffrey had LoJack, the most successful theft recovery system on Earth, and the only one with a 90% recovery rate.
Majestic sight of Panasonic Toyota Racing's TF108 sweeping through corners at speed is the public face of Formula One. But away from the Grand Prix track, there is another hidden world of continuous technical development. A world that increasingly relies on digital simulation.
I think we live in a digital world now, we have to recognize that, and in Formula One we are pushing the limits of simulation and the utilization of computer power to absolutely understand where the performance can be found in the future. So even if we still use track testing or wind tunnel testing, normally the area that we're looking in is predefined by computer simulation. And we're looking in a fruitful area where we can cultivate performance.
Simulation technologies are used by many departments within Panasonic Toyota Racing. For example, in its preparations for the Canadian Grand Prix, the team uses a so-called seven-post rig. It's a sophisticated system of hydraulic rams that can exactly recreate the suspension movements of any of last year's Grand Prix races. It's particularly important for the race in Montreal.
It's very important because contrary to other circuits, you have these chicanes where the more you can ride the kerbs, the more you can straight line them and the more time you're going to gain. That means if you have a car that handles perfect over the kerbs, you take them with you and you're going to gain a lot of speed and lap time just only in the chicanes, which you don't have to gain on the rest of the circuit.
Similarly, the engine department uses its test bench or dyno rig to simulate a lap on any circuit where telemetry data has previously been collected from the car.
Typically before Canada or any other race, we have in our computer the complete throttle behavior that maybe can reproduce Jarno's driving style or even a virtual driver that is trying to make his lap time in this with a dyno. And in this way, we can already start to anticipate some potential problem in terms of engine response or engine mapping that the driver and the team can find directly in Canada.
Perhaps even more useful is the almost real-time application of this technology. During the Grand Prix weekend, engine data can be sent back to the factory for simulation tests.
For example, if during the weekend a driver experiences a particular problem in a certain corner, we can download all the data, reproduce it at home, work with the right time, with the right tools here, and then hopefully to give some suggestion to help the people on the track.
In the aerodynamics department, a combination of wind tunnel and computer simulation technologies also provides useful guidelines.
Obviously, we have a very large wind tunnel facility in addition to a very good computational fluid dynamic resource, which is effectively trying to reproduce the wind tunnel in the computer. In the wind tunnel, we have a very complex arrangement whereby we try and replicate the track conditions as realistic as possible. In CFD, we then try and match the model and the computational model to the tunnel, so we can try and improve the correlation from CFD to the tunnel to the track.
While simulation is increasingly important at Panasonic Toyota Racing, the team is careful to keep these techniques in perspective.
No, you cannot trust simulation, because simulation is just simulation. The simulation is just as good as your department, your simulation department is, and in any case it faces, I would say, natural limitations. So what is essential when you use simulation is to know exactly the limits of it. You cannot expect the simulation to tell you exactly how stiff your suspension has to be. What you can expect from the simulation is to give you directions. It will give you a diagnostic. So simulation is all about the way you use it, because simulation is not the reality.
Simulation is indeed not the reality. And despite all the complex technology, for millions of fans around the world, that reality will always be defined by the sight and sound of an F1 car driven in anger.
You know, you can search the AutoChannel.com's new car buyer's guide to quickly and easily find specs, prices, multi-car comparison, and the latest news about every new passenger car and truck sold in North America. TheAutoChannel.com, there's nothing else like it.